All right, in depth with Tone X in a minute, but Monique is here too. And so we're going to chat about the
little
It's very good to see you. Couple things we got to ask you about.
Yes.
You know, we talked about this before the light went on. You have a thought about the whole thing with Roseanne.
I do. I really do. Should we wait for the break or should we share
No,
right
we'll
now?
Share right now.
You know, Roseanne Barr is my sister in comedy, and she's my universal sister. And what I won't do, Sam, is throw her away for making a mistake. We've all said and done things, baby, that we wish we could take back and swallow and say, oh, but when you're in the public eye, you can't, and it's out there. But to put the title of racist on her, I can only share my experience with Roseanne. I remember when I had the Monique show, and there were big, major black superstar talent that had white representatives, and they told their talent, that show was too black, and we really don't want you to go on there. But there was a white woman named Roseanne Barr that showed up for me when people that looked like me. Now, that, I want to thank all the talent that came on the Monique show because there were some beautiful people that sat on that couch. But I remember when we were going after the big names and it was, oh, we got to get back to you. And y'all know who you saw and who you didn't see on that show.
Right.
But that woman, when we called, it wasn't a question. And she came and she sat on that sofa and they didn't hear the conversation when the cameras wasn't rolling. And that woman was giving me some beautiful words. And she said, Monique, I'm gonna tell you right now, baby, they're gonna consider you difficult. They're gonna call you the B word because you're a woman who won't lay down and take that foolishness. So what I would ask is, yes, my sister made a mistake. And she said something that I know she wished she could take back. But what I would ask is that we don't throw her away. The consequence is what the consequence is. But I know what it is, Sam, to be thrown away based off of a lie. I know that feeling to have to fight for something when you're only fighting for equality. You're fighting for what's right and what's fair. So when I see my sister who said something out of order, out of line, she did. We cannot dress it up.
Right.
But when I see my sister saying, I made a mistake. So all I would say is to Roseanne, baby, if you are in California right now, you have tickets to the show at the Brea Improv. Because what I won't do,
bring me some.
When someone says they're sorry, and we keep teaching all of this Christianity and all of this forgiveness, but when we write in it, we seem to forget about that. And we seem to walk away from it. So for Roseanne Barr from Monique, I want to say to my sister, I love you. I know you made a mistake. I know you messed up. But I still won't throw you away. I won't put you on the racist list and say, oh, never again. That is my sister. And I think these are the moments that really count. Because I remember somebody asked me, Sam, for, with the situation that I'm going through. And they were asking my husband about it. And they said, well, what do you say about the people that don't speak out, that don't say anything, and they know what, you know, Monique is dealing with? He said, in history, you find out who your friends are when you're going through something. Either in their silence or in their speaking out.
Right.
You find out. So I want Roseanne Barr to know, sister, you have a friend in me. You have a friend in me. To Sister Valerie, you have a friend in me. Because when we talk about this unity and this sisterhood, I would like to see those two women come together. And Roseanne, you've got to give her an apology. You got to say, I'm sorry. But the spirit that I know of Valerie would say, hey, baby. But let's not us jump on the bandwagon of balling us up and throwing us away.
Can I bring up another B word? It's a B word that's been associated now with you and your career and this word blackballed.
Yes.
Do you feel you have been blackballed?
At this point, yes, Sam.
Okay.
And, you know, people keep saying to me, why don't you move on? Why don't you let it go? And then when you know our history of Hollywood and Black Hollywood, they told Eartha Kitt the same thing. They told Paul Robeson the same thing. They told Hattie McDaniel the same thing. And the list goes on and on and on. So when Lee Daniels first told me I was blackballed, I said, that's what he said. But then you begin to see it unravel. You begin to see deals that you had that just went away. You begin to see things not make sense. And when I say Lee Daniels, when I say Tyler Perry, when I say Oprah Winfrey, I'm unapologetic and I'm unwavering about it. Because when I see this woman, Oprah Winfrey, and she goes and she speaks to the hashtag Me Too, which is appreciated. But how do you as a black woman watch another black woman be thrown under the bus based off of a lie? So again, the blackball thing, it's very real. But what I won't do is be quiet. I won't go away. I won't back down. I won't say it quietly. I won't write a letter. Sam, I got a big mouth. Don't you know it?
Yes.
We've experienced each other for quite some time,
absolutely.
Sam. This mouth right here, they say it ain't over till the fat lady sings. I ain't sung yet, Sam.
And by the way, no fat lady, you look fantastic.
Thank you, Sammy.
What are you doing?
You know what I'm doing? I'm doing this new thing called being loved and knowing how to love back. And people think that's such a cliche, but when you fall in love, you want that. Don't you want that feeling, Mark? Don't you want to wake up to that and you want to go to bed to that?
Right.
So I had to make a decision. And that decision was I had to watch what I put in my mouth. I'm going to pause on that. And I'm back. Right? Okay.
I'm going to drink some water.
And I had to really be committed to working out and really saying, I want a lifetime with my husband. And I want to meet my children's children. Well, you got to put in the work to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also, I work out this hard because being in them comedy clubs, on them stages, in these heels, baby, that takes work. You hear what I'm saying? That takes work. And my heels is 4 inches. That takes work.
Todex, what it's like to share the stage with Monique? You're part of the show at the Brea Improv. You've obviously performed with her before.
Incredible. It's incredible. It's, you learn, you live, and you laugh. I get to learn from one of the best comedians, but one of the best spirits. Maybe sometimes misunderstood, but one of the best spirits as a human being. And someone who, like my man Bernie Mac on the Kings of Comedy, when I did that tour, he would pull me to the side every night and he would talk to me more about being a good person, better man, versus being a better comedian. Same here. Her husband and my wife are first cousins.
So for all of y'all that thought that me and Tone had something happening, this is my cousin. We not kissing cousins,
right.
We just cousins.
I never saw that come down my feed on Twitter.
I didn't either, but I just wanted to throw it out there.
See if it sticks. So it's great, man. Right. It's fun.
And
fun,
I love that you guys, when you sat down before the interview started, you looked at each other and said, I love you. And you said, I love you too. And a real genuine, deep.
Right, but you didn't hear my response, did you?
I did not, I love you back.
And she was like, I love you. I said, I love you back. But then I leaned in and I said, that's how you talk to somebody when you're getting ready to let them go. You know what I mean?
I love you.
All right, no more dates.
Let me show you a clip. This is from, I think, 2009, talking with me and Jess on the Oscar red carpet. So watch this. Take a look at this. Let me ask you this. All of a sudden, we've laughed with you, Queens of Comedy, all the TV work, so you're hilarious. And then, here's this other thing that a lot of people, myself included, didn't know you could do. Now we know you can do it. Has Hollywood come calling in a big way?
You know how it works, Sam. I miss those earrings.
You miss those earrings? But I mean, that performance in Precious is indelible and historic and Oscar winning. Should you be doing more of that?
Should I be doing what? More,
more
acting?
More acting, yeah.
I'm so glad we're having this open, honest conversation. Of course I should, because they say once you win that award, that's the biggest award.
That's what they say.
That you can win in this industry. However, after I won that award, the offers were coming in as if I just got off the Greyhound bus. And when I said, guys, I can't accept that, because if I accept it, the little black girl that's not born yet, guess what she gonna walk into? She gonna walk into that too. So it wasn't that the offers wasn't coming, but it was coming in as if I was brand new to Hollywood. And you know, I used to have this agent at William Morris. And when I first came to Hollywood, she was my agent. And I won't say her name, because I don't know if she's ready for me to say her name, but she's no longer with William Morris. And for some years, we would get into these really deep conversations. And one day I said, you're a racist. And she said, how could you say that to me? I'm offended. I said, because you are. And we parted our relationship. We got back in contact with each other about 2 weeks ago. And that woman said to me, Mo, I was a racist. And I'm so sorry. She said, from the fear, I didn't know what to do and I didn't know how to protect you. And what you were saying was right. And she said, when I started hearing that your husband was difficult, she said, I know, Sydney, She said, you know what makes Sidney difficult? He's a black man that walked up into a room full of white people. And the moment he began to speak is the moment he became difficult. So I was appreciative. And that's what makes a person a good person. Because, and that's how I feel about Roseanne. When you're able to come back and say, you know what? I was a traditional racist. And we have a lot of traditional racism going on in this country. For you to say things for you, where it's like, I didn't know I was saying anything wrong because that's how I grew up. That's what I was taught. Mm-hmm. But when you're able to come back and say, I was wrong about that. And when you have a white woman that was an agent that validates what you're saying, and she says, Mo, it is unequal. It is unfair. Y'all are underpaid. Then I know I'm not on the wrong track.
You know what? You can meet Monique and Tonex.
Laugh yes, you can.
Brea Improv, Friday, July 27th.
And the words are going to be spicier.
Saturday, July 28th.
Y'all know right now.
Ticket information, go to brea.improv.com. Good to see you.
Thank you, guys.
Quick break. We're back here in a second.